G'day guys, and welcome back to another 12 volt video. Now today, I'm gonna be talking about solar regulators or solar controllers, in particular, the two most common types, PWM and MPPT. And in this video, I'm gonna be going through how they work, their differences, and why one might be better than the other for your setup. Now a 12 volt solar panel is generally putting out somewhere around 18 to 20 volts, which is why it's so important that you need a regulator. If you simply plugged your solar blanket or solar panel into your battery, it'd work at first, but then as the charging voltage climbs, it'll eventually cook your battery. That's no good. Back in the day, there wasn't much choice when it came to solar regulators or solar controllers. You basically had an on-off switch, so that when the sun was out and your battery was discharged, the switch would be on and it would charge up your battery. Once your battery hit that high voltage point where it didn't need any more, you'd have to turn it off, or it'd turn off to stop cooking the battery. Now that wasn't particularly efficient and it didn't charge the battery properly. These days though, you've got much better options. So let's see what you need for your setup. To start with, let's talk about PWM. PWM stands for pulse width modulation, and that's describing what this unit's doing when it's charging your battery. So to start with, it pulses power into the battery, and it can actually change the amount of time or the length or width of that charge, and that is modulating. So it's actually modulating the length of the pulse. That might sound fairly technical, so let's take a look at a graph to make it easier to understand. On the vertical axis of the graph, it's showing your voltage. And on the horizontal axis is the time. As you can see, when the regulator turns on, it's at voltage, then turns off for a short period of time before it turns on again. Every time the regulator turns off, it measures the voltage of the battery and adjusts for the next pulse. And you might have noticed that on this graph, the charging voltage is 13 volts. That's because when you connect a PWM regulator to a solar panel and battery, the large load of the battery actually pulls the solar panel voltage down to just above the battery voltage. They're not able to actually boost that voltage any higher. The voltage will simply increase as the battery charges up. Then the regulator will output the higher voltage but shorten the width of each pulse. Now let's talk about that in the real world. So let's use this 200 watt solar blanket as an example. Now I do have the exact specs, but to make it easier, let's assume it's putting out 20 volts and 10 amps. 20 volts times 10 amps is 200 watts. Once you connect this to your PWM regulator, the battery will pull that voltage down to around 13 volts. And because it's not actually able to boost the output power, you're now at 13 volts times 10 amps for a total of 130 watts. So your 200 watt solar blanket is only able to put out 130 watts. So as your battery's charging up and that internal voltage does climb, let's say it gets right up to 14.5 volts, still getting 10 amps, you're now at 145 watts. But unfortunately, you're never gonna get the full 200 watts out of a PWM regulator. So why would you want a PWM regulator? Well, here's a list of pros and cons that might help you out. One massive advantage is their cost. PWM regulators are fairly inexpensive, which means you can get into a solar setup without a massive entry cost. Secondly, they're tested technology, and they're arguably more reliable and durable because they have much less complex technology inside. Now, the cons for a PWM regulator. Number one is that because they only charge at battery voltage or just above it, they're only around 70% efficient. They can't boost the voltage or amperage that's coming out of the unit. Secondly, they can't use 24 volt solar panels, so you can't take advantage of a higher voltage for less voltage drop in your system. These can only run with what's called a 12 volt solar panel, putting out around that 18 to 20 volt number. Finally, they're not that ideal for a larger solar system, which doesn't matter too much if you're only talking about camping or four-wheel driving, but you have to be mindful of it if you do ever want to grow your solar array. Let's get on to MPPT regulators next. Now, MPPT stands for Maximum Power Point Tracking, but that's not all it does. The first difference between an MPPT and a PWM is where the PWM simply connects the circuit and brings your solar panel output right down to your battery voltage. An MPPT is two separate circuits. So whatever's coming in is able to go through a computer and then be outputted at a different level. This is a more technically advanced system, which means it's gonna charge your batteries much better. Now let's use the same example as before with a 200 watt panel and take a look at a graph of an MPPT regulator. Hypothetically, let's say we've got 200 watts. That's going into the input side of your MPPT regulator or controller. If your battery needs 13 volts to charge, the MPPT will take that 200 watts, divide it by the 13 volt output that's required, and then output the same amount of power minus a tiny inefficiency as what it's receiving. So it'll put out 13 volts, but at around 15 amps. So as well as actually taking advantage of the entire amount of power that's coming out of your solar panel, an MPPT has another advantage as well, and that is in the name, maximum power point tracking. So as an example, let's say that the maximum power point of this solar panel sits around here on this graph. As a cloud passes over, it's going to drop the output considerably. But the MPPT regulator is able to constantly track, scanning for that maximum power point and output it. A PWM can't do that. It's simply a passive system. And what this means is that as the solar panel heats up or loses efficiency, clouds pass over, or you might have a tiny bit of partial shade on your panel, the MPPT is always able to make the most of it and output the maximum power. So let's talk the pros and cons of an MPPT regulator and why you might want one. Well, first of all, they're much more efficient than a PWM regulator. Secondly, they're more able to use the entire output of your solar panel, because they're not just passively dropping the voltage to your battery voltage and then using as much current as they can. These are able to actually boost up that current to use the entire panel output. Thirdly, because they can track that maximum power point, even in low light, cloudy conditions, or as the panel heats up, they're able to put out more power more efficiently than a PWM. And last, because they're able to actually input a larger voltage, you're not restricted to using 12 volt nominal solar panels. So you could use a higher voltage solar panel for less voltage drop in your system, which equals more power getting into your batteries. Now the cons of an MPPT regulator, number one, they're generally a bit bigger and heavier than a PWM of the same capacity, but it's not usually a big deal. Number two, because they're more advanced inside, they're generally more expensive. It's all well and good to talk about the differences of these regulators on the bench, but what's much more important is to see their actual real-world performance. So let's take them outside and compare them. Both batteries are discharged to around 12.7 volts, or about 75% capacity, and they've been sitting overnight. We're using the same solar blanket, both laying flat on the ground, which isn't ideal, but it's a good comparison. Connecting both panels up, the PWM instantly connects the circuit, while the MPPT calculates that maximum power point. After about 30 minutes in the sun, you can see that the battery voltage is already climbing, the panels are heating up, there's voltage drop in the system, and it's not a perfectly bright day, so we're not at full power. The PWM is putting in around 3 amps or 40 watts of charge, while the MPPT is taking advantage of the extra power and charging it over 7 amps or just over 100 watts. So in summary, the MPPT is putting out more than double the power of the PWM. The losses in the system, the fact that it's not a perfectly bright day, and the heat of the panels mean that we're not getting a full 200 watts. But you can see that in the real world, that's where the MPPT makes such a massive difference. So if you want a simple, inexpensive option that's going to work in most situations, then you can't go past a PWM. However, if you want to make the most of the entire amount of power that your panel's able to put out, and ensure that your battery's getting the highest charge it can, you'll need to step up to an MPPT. Now, this is a fairly shallow look at what is a very in-depth topic. So if you do have any questions, make sure you throw them in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit like, and remember to hit subscribe and the notification bell so you don't miss our next one. Finally, thanks for watching.